I prepare 10 pages, and scusami I miei amici italiani, io parlerò in...
I'm sorry for my Italian friends, but I will speak in English because I prepared my speech in English. Because I thought that in this way more people could understand me.
All the thoughts and things and beautiful things that were said here. But I believe, like Johannes, that really art is one of the only things that are we do without any purpose, we do because I do, for example, because I have to do, and I can't do without. And this kind of purity of the people that are doing things, I think we can see in several parts of society where they do something without the economic interest, the human interest, and I think the artist could or should sometimes being aware of this foggy haze of reality, sometimes you have insights to see things that people don't see, that are really obvious. And I like to quote sometimes Wilhelm Flusser, this media philosopher that was born in Czechoslovakia, lived in Brazil, and come back to Europe in the late 90s, and he used to say that we live in a Plato's cave, and the shadows we are seeing are not the reality that we are seeing, and I will try to illustrate a bit here. Everything started, this speech started with this Plato's idea, and this is my 11-year-old kid, and she was playing with her hands in the park in Berlin the other day, the thing of the shadow that she was playing, she was starting to think that the shadow of the hands were reality. Today we are bombarded with images like this that show the reality. Photograph is told to us, video and news and texts and newspapers, that this is the reality. But sometimes the reality can be different and can be instrumentalized. So this paradox in this two realities here, where we see a teenager being shot in Africa, this photo on my right side won a prize for best photo. But to be sincere, these photographers that are there are nothing. I don't think they are artists. I don't think they are in search of real truth. I don't think. So for me, these two photos, it's kind of a snapshot, what is happening in the mass media in our reality today. And we are here in this meeting to talk about art and conflict and peace, and I don't want to be corny I don't want to be superficial, but I would like to talk about that. I think every one of us is linked by this feeling that we don't really know where we come from and where we're going to. Even if we can explain philosophically, theologically, we don't really know, we don't have a clue, we don't have this certainty. And according to my living things, we have a few things of that I feel that they are electromagnetic things that all happened in this planet, and what make us to think that the only really right, the only thing which is really absolute is the not absolute, is the movement, is the thing that everything is changing, is growing, is changing all the time, and that these laws of electromagnetic, which is like attraction and refraction, those two laws. We are now here having this meeting. This is a kind of attraction thing. It's a kind of a positive attitude. Is a positive form of thing. Some people, as the Romans used to say, divide impera, divide and you rule. So it's, if you do this, it's because you're going to try to rule, and you have a second meaning, and this is kind of a I would say like negative, evil kind of feeling. And I think we can explain everything with these three characteristics: movement, refraction, and attraction. This pathos, this suffering, is one of the first things that united us. And to placate this pain, this, we are hunger or starving for meaning. And what people really want are meaning. So I would like to, I don't know, everyone I think here more or less know, but I would like one of the first people that are talking about Western civilization also, because I think, absolutely, I think we are very limited and we use very few of our brains and we can't comprehend everything. So I'm departing from this. And I was educated in a Western society. In this Western society, which is limited, talks that the thought that is talking about what I'm going to surpass this pain of this pathos of living, was the pre-Socratic society that says that life is tragic and there is this tragedy that we have to accept. Then the Judaism, the Christianism, the Islamism, they said that we can overcome this pain through faith. Then the Illuminism can. There are several kinds of explanations, and they're all mixed in this world. And the Illuminists say that we can overcome this through reason, and this is more or less. And then there is Schopenhauer, Nietzsche, Wittgenstein, two our days, other forms of thoughts. And there is psychology, there is Freud, Jung, and but this main thing that we so far we are still, I think, influenced by this Illuminism, that we think with our reason, with our science, with our technology, we can explain everything, and we are so stupid that we think we can explain everything. And but you cannot. And we are living now, after so many fall of values, we are living now in a vacuum, and especially that these two world wars made in this planet. The First World War was the first time that new technology, tanks, submarines, airplanes were used to kill people, gases, in the Second World War also, even more, with the atomic bombs. And in this vacuum of most of the contemporary thinkers, they said that art is dead, everything is dead, civilization is dead, politics can do anything, religion can do anything, there is war religion. So there is this trend of our world today, which you see in the mass media. They're not telling us, but they are telling us in a way that something is wrong, and there is no, and after the Berlin Wall, which is really, there's not even ideological duality. Everything is made through, unfortunately, to a way of sell and consume products and goods. That's the thing that counts today, or in the last. So everything is like to sell. Nobody's trying to tell you something deeply. Everyone is trying to sell you something. Everyone is trying to, every time, to not have a real meaning of the things, and to say a truth. And people think they are, most of the people that think they are authorized to be the truth, sometimes they are not. So I think this meeting is so important, that have this attempt of us to create with our minds and our hearts and our a new form of materialization of a thing. Because I think we as humans and we as artists, we are keep on trying to imagine it, a project that do become true. And I think the decision makers of the world today are people that studied politics, economics, financial things. And I think numbers can't say the truth. Just numbers can't go anywhere. It's going to be the end of the civilization if you carry on like this. This thing, everything that the world as it is leading to a dead end. We have no other chance. So probably now is the great chance to get all together in a table and to start to exchange. But I think we that are talking about being in Europe, that we are a little bit one of the privileged people in this earth, I think should start with us, because the privileged people we have to give up of something, of some things as well. You have to start from ourselves, from our neighbor and our small things. I prepared a 10-sheet dialogue talking about philosophy and things, but I'm joking. Of course, I won't. I came here. I talked to my friend Alessandro Zucchi, that I would talk about this new work I'm doing, which is kind of to talk about refraction and attraction. I would say about, I like this dichotomies. I would talk about also, I would like to talk about authority and identity. And the last work that Paul mentioned was this work that was in Venice, was talking about the alterity, the other that I don't know, and I have to not to accept, but to love almost. And it was a real experience of love, and it was a natural thing that concluded. And I one day in 2009, when I was in the very beginning, we were talking about with several of our friends. And for example, Miralem came, and he was playing around, and I said, look, this is really serious, because we are doing a real serious thing. This is, we're talking about art. And we can go even to the Venice Biennale to show in public this thing. And they start, the 200 people that I was working in Sant'Egidio Lab, start to believe it. And I think this belief and this thing creates half of reality. Nobody thought really to go to Venice, but then, mysteriously or heavenly, we went to Venice. But I think it was their belief. And the conclusion is that the day of the presentation, one of our friends, Franchino, said, "Oh, thanks, César, that you came here and you work with us, or with me," he said. But so this was the conclusion that the project called I is Another, Je suis un autre, un altro, and it's a Rambo thing, and it calls about this interpretation of alterity. And, well, the thing I came here to speak about and to show some pieces that I'm still in a early research of this thing about identity, because I think knowing identity knowing ourselves, we are going really to know where we are going to. So, okay. I am an artist. I'm not entitled to talk. And I would like you to see the works. They were going to be available online and on the site. And I think, so it's okay. I spoke for 13 minutes only. I have still 1 minute. I'm counting.
You're supposed to stick to 10 minutes.
Merci de nous avoir conduits dans la.
Thank you.